Good morning, Derrick Chevalier here. Welcome to CCN Sunrise. My guest this morning, Tim Ferreira, he's here this morning to talk about the Libertarian Party, the candidates, and we're going to talk about some of the issues. So I understand that you have the distinction of garnering more votes than any other third-party candidate. Tell us a little bit about that, Tim.
So for the lieutenant governor, I got 99,949 votes, just shy of 100,000 votes. My mom was rooting for the 100,000. Yeah. She kept hitting refresh on the browser trying to see it pop up, but just 51 shy. And so that's more than any other candidate for lieutenant governor on a third-party ticket. And we had another candidate, Gail Lightfoot, on Secretary of State, who did the exact same thing. She got more votes than any other candidate.
I actually saw that. So tell us, there are five folks. Well, first of all, tell us a little bit about what are the distinguishing aspects of the Libertarian Party.
If I had to do it in a soundbite, it would be don't hurt people, don't take your stuff. Okay, it's just a real simple kind of philosophy.
That's simple.
But it's amazing how other political philosophies tend to violate one or both of those on a regular basis.
So if you go straight from there to some of the issues and then how various candidates of the libertarian persuasion might look at these, let's talk about immigration. What would be the libertarian take on immigration?
Immigration, open borders, right? All the way to open borders. We understand that there are some bad people that want to get into this country, and we need to do our best to try and keep them out, but let's err on the side of letting people in versus keeping people out. If you go back to, the symbol of the Libertarian Party is the Liberty Torch, right? And the Statue of Liberty, bring me your huddled masses, right? How poetic is that? And we really believe that that's the stance that we should be taking as a nation. You know, bring those people here, let them come, let them make a better life for themselves. If you go back to the Declaration of Independence, we hold these truths to be self-evident. All men are created equal. It'd be nice if it said all men and women, but hey, we won't talk about that right now. And it talks about inalienable rights given to us by our Creator.
But you're not suggesting that it's a right to come into the country.
I am suggesting that the rights that we have here in the United States are inalienable rights that are part of being human being. Whether or not you were born on some other side of an imaginary line somewhere in the world, that's a right that you have, and if it's not being honored in that country where you were born, you should have the right to come here and have that right be honored.
Okay, so how would the libertarian perspective see the president's wall, for example?
A lot of things about what the president is doing is because we've given too much power to the office of the president. And so we would want to walk back a lot of the power that we've even given to that office. It's been eroded over the years. But no, we wouldn't believe in a wall. We would believe in, maybe a little guard with a little check stand kind of thing, and that's about it.
And then how would you propose dealing with some of the impact of having everybody come over the border with less checks and less balances? What about, would we then have to beef up security? What would we do to solve some of the greater issues?
Well, a lot of the reasons why people want to hurt us is our interactions with them on their home soil around the world. And the Libertarian Party also believes in ending wars and not going into other countries and fighting on their turf. Having a strong defense, making sure that we can protect our own, but not going out there and doing other things.
Well, let's look at another issue, taxes. So we've got to pay for people to provide health insurance and care of their sick coming across the borders. How do we deal with the taxes and the costs of providing for all those people coming into the country?
So just like any political party, there are extremists in all parties, right? And so if you go all the way to the extreme in the Libertarian Party, you've got anarchists who believe that there shouldn't be any government and everything should be voluntary. I fall just a little bit short of that, but we do believe in voluntary systems, that if there is something that is worthwhile for society to believe in, then society should pay for that, not through a tax, but through voluntary means.
So what example would you give that system would work here in the United States in the 21st century? What evidence?
Well, we have all sorts of evidence here in the United States throughout time, but as well as service organizations. You take an organization like Rotary, right? They are working to eradicate polio throughout the world, and they have a lot of large donors like Bill Gates and such that have come in and said, that's a cause I believe in. It's not a government cause. It's a private cause, and they're working towards that issue.
So tell us about the five candidates that are running still in the race for the Libertarian Party.
Okay. Five of us made it to the general election, and I'm going to try and get this right off of memory. State Assembly District 4, which is near Napa area, and that is Brandon Nelson. State Assembly District 21 is Justin Quigley, and that's he's running in my hometown where I was born, which is in Modesto, the Stanislaus County, Merced County area. And then down here in Southern California, we've got Christopher Stair, that's State Assembly 51. We've got Honor Mimi Robson, which is State Assembly 70, which is the Long Beach area. And then in Orange County, Autumn Brown, who is the daughter of one of our previous presidential candidates.
Thanks so much, and thank you for being on. How can our guests find out, or our viewers find out more about the Libertarian Party?
So we've got a website here in California. It's ca.lp.org, so CaliforniaLibertarianParty.org.
Well, you heard it right here. So go ahead and take a look at the website. Give some consideration to the Libertarian view.